Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2021 Army Birthday Showcase, presented by your very own United States Army. I'm Lieutenant Colonel Clydelia Pritchard Allen, and I am excited to be coming to you from Fort Meade, Maryland, as we honor the courage of the American soldier. For 246 years, the United States Army has been and remains the greatest fighting force in the world as we continue to train, fight, and win our nation's wars. Our motto, "This Will Defend," dates back to the American Revolution and still holds true to this day. It's an expression of our readiness and the essence of our service as Army soldiers and civilians. As an all-volunteer force, we are truly America's Army. And every person's deep commitment to preserving and defending our Constitution makes our Army what it is. No matter the challenges we face as a nation, our Army will always be there when needed. Coming up, we're going to hear from some of our senior leaders and enjoy some wonderful music performed by the United States Army Field Band, the musical ambassadors of the Army. But first, let's head over to the new National Museum of the United States Army, where we will hear from Lieutenant General Jason T. Evans, Deputy Chief of Staff G9, who is responsible for the integration and policy for all Army installations and leads the Army's Quality of Life Task Force.
Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel Pritchard Allen. Happy birthday, Army. Greetings from the Army's National Museum. For over 246 years, the Army has answered the call to service whenever needed by the nation in support of domestic or foreign threat, a natural or man-made disaster, and even a public health crisis, as evident today during the COVID-19 pandemic. We are honored to lead this year's Army Birthday Showcase. We have a remarkable program planned for you, which includes remarks by our Army senior leadership, interviews, soldier-led musical entertainment, and a special guest to assist us in celebrating the Army's birthday. So, to begin our event, let's join the U.S. Army Field Band and Soldiers Chorus as they perform our national anthem.
Soldier and DA civilian who raises their right hand wants to bring their best to the table, to be all they can be. That old marketing slogan spoke to opportunity in the Army. Today, there are more than 150 ways to serve as a soldier or civilian in the regular Army, Army Reserve, and National Guard throughout the world. The diverse talents of its people are what makes this such a great Army. All the individuals that make up our team doing what they do best for the same cause. So even in the 21st century, be all you can be still resonates today.
just trying to be a mother, raise a daughter and a son, be a lover to their father, everything to everyone. Up and out and bright and early, I'm all business in my suit. Yeah, I'm dressed up for success, from my head down to my boots. I don't do it for the money, there's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory, I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures, my responsibility. Yeah, I'm real good under pressure, being all that I can be. And I can't call in sick on Mondays when the weekend's been too strong. I just work three through the holidays, and sometimes all night long. You can bet that I stand ready when the wolf growls at the door. Hey, I'm solid, hey, I'm steady, hey, I'm true down to the core. And I will always do my duty, no matter what the price. I've counted up the cost, I know the sacrifice. Oh, and I don't wanna die for you, but if dying's asking me, I'll bear the cross with honor, 'cause freedom don't come free. I'm an American soldier, an American, beside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty is in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, so sleep in peace tonight.
Thank you, Six String Soldiers, for adding a special touch to this event through your music. And now, let's hear a message from two of our Army's senior leaders, the 40th Chief of Staff of the Army, General James C. McConville, and the 16th Sergeant Major of the Army, Sergeant Major Michael A. Grinston.
As we celebrate the 246th birthday of the United States Army, we honor all those who serve and strive to live up to the legacy of our heroes have gone before us.
When the nation called, the Army responded. This past year, our soldiers and civilians have protected the nation from threats around the world, while supporting the fight against coronavirus, responding to civil unrest, and protecting Americans from hurricanes and wildfires here at home.
It is truly a privilege to serve with the greatest soldiers in the world.
Happy birthday, United States Army.
People first,
winning matters,
and we remain Army strong.
This year marks 246 years of the U.S. Army, serving and defending our country. Since our Army's establishment, June 14th, 1775, soldiers and Army civilians have been there in support of our nation.
Bearing true faith and allegiance to the U.S. Constitution, the Army, our units,
raise your right hand,
and fellow team members.
Understand there will always be
unknowns,
surprises,
and most importantly, the fear of the journey.
Now ask yourself,
how much courage did it take
to raise your right hand?
Honestly, my biggest fear is being away from my mom too long. It's like my superhero. But I knew if she was there to be supportive for me, then I could do it for her.
How much courage did it take
to dedicate your all to something greater?
Greater than just yourself.
To your country.
Your nation.
You know, this will be my first unit as a second lieutenant, so I'm looking forward to all the challenges that may come my way.
You looked inward
and found your inner strength.
That courage,
the fire within,
driving you to be part of the team. You give your all.
You train.
You fight.
You bleed.
You grow.
You repeat. As we grow, we learn about our true courage.
I'm the type of person that if you tell me I can't do something, I have to prove you wrong.
The courage it takes to make the necessary sacrifices.
The courage it takes to say goodbye.
To ignore the tears of those you love more than yourself.
To do what's necessary to protect them.
Your loved ones. Your nation.
I actually connect more than when I was previously there because of how much you realize that you miss somebody when you're not there all the time, and you can't be.
You have to have the courage to make it through all the sacrifices.
Fortunately,
you're not alone.
Because everybody comes from a different background and everybody's got an obstacle they're overcoming when they come to the Army. It could be personal, it could be their situation. But the Army provides to a lot of soldiers the opportunity to overcome that obstacle or overcome that glass ceiling and become something greater for themselves and something greater for a nation as well.
Service is not always easy.
Nor forgiving.
But the journey is rewarding.
You are part of something greater than yourself.
Your family now.
Your brothers and sisters are there for you, to teach you,
to guide you,
to watch over you.
For me, it's about investing in the development of our future generation of leaders, investing in our soldiers.
While we have lost some warriors along the way,
they remain within our ranks.
Legacy.
And history. May our warriors never be forgotten.
It's not easy.
Being an Army veteran, I realize and learn that your work and your work ethic represents you.
Those veterans will serve in a new capacity now.
As you look back on your life.
As you reflect on the soldier you are.
Will become.
Recognize your inner strength.
Be grateful for the courage you have.
And be proud of what you represent.
We are the United States Army.
This year, Arlington National Cemetery commemorates the 100th anniversary of the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. In March of 1921, Congress passed legislation to lay to rest an unknown soldier from the battlefields of France with the purpose to bring home the body of an unknown American warrior who in himself represents no section, creed, or race in the late war, and who typifies, moreover, the soul of America and the supreme sacrifice of her heroic dead. Today, soldiers from the 3rd U.S. Infantry Regiment, known as the Old Guard, are tasked to safeguard and conduct ceremonies daily at the tomb. Their continued efforts ensure that the service and sacrifice of those we've lost are never forgotten.
Thank you.
So you think you can tell heaven from hell, blue skies from pain? Can you tell a green field from a cold steel rail, a smile from a veil? Do you think you can tell? Did they get you to trade your heroes for ghosts, hot ashes for trees, hot air for the cool breeze, cold comfort for change? Did you exchange a walk-on part in the war for the lead role?
The latest addition to the Army family is our new secretary, Honorable Christine Warmoth, who now becomes the first female in 246 years to lead our Army. Ladies and gentlemen, the 25th Secretary of the Army, Honorable Christine Warmoth.
This year's Army birthday theme is honoring the courage of the American soldier. It is a distinct privilege to serve alongside the finest men and women our great nation has to offer. For 246 years, the Army has been the world's greatest land fighting force. From the Revolutionary War to present-day operations, the Army is always there to preserve the peace and security of the nation while working closely with our allies and partners. But the fight isn't always thousands of miles away. In recent years, the Army has been needed on the home front more than ever. From the COVID-19 response, where we surged life-saving support to cities around the country by administering and distributing vaccines, to our soldiers ensuring that First Amendment rights were protected during periods of civil unrest. No matter what comes our way, our Army remains ready. Each challenge the Army has faced comes with its own heroes, our own records of incredible bravery, and bonds developed in the most trying of times. It's fitting that we acknowledge the incredible competence, enduring commitment, and extraordinary character of not only our soldiers, but our civilians and veterans and their families who have sacrificed so greatly in defense of American values. I am incredibly proud to see how we continue to honor our oath to protect the constitutional rights of the American people and safeguard our nation. Happy 246 years of celebrated Army history, because the Army's history is our nation's history. Let's join with the United States Army Field Band and the Soldiers Chorus in the playing of the official song of the United States Army.
Who have fought to victory. We're As we bring the program to a close, there are many people I would like to thank for making this event happen. I would like to start by saying thank you to the viewers. Thank you for taking the time to join us for this amazing celebration, and thank you for your United States Army. Thanks again to our guests, our distinguished leaders, our featured soldiers and veterans, the United States Army Field Band, and our MC, Lieutenant Colonel Pritchard Allen, for a job well done. I also want to give special shout out to the 2021 Army Birthday Showcase Task Force led by Colonel Jared Thomas. With support from the G9 team and organizations within the Department of the Army and the Military District of Washington. Please take this opportunity to visit the National Museum online or in person. It is a remarkable representation of our soldiers' stories and our history. I will leave you with one last thought. Continue to keep our men and women who are in harm's way in your thoughts and prayers. God bless you, our Army, our nation, people first, winning matters, Army strong.